Hi guys, it's iBizarre Rappers here today, bringing you a new FIFA 13 video. Today it's going to be a career mode with Wolves. The reason why I'm a bit quieter is I'm not feeling too good. I've had a bit of a headache, but I still want to do a video for you. And today it's going to be two matches that I've been talking about. We've got Wickham in the Capital One Cup, and then we've got a first game of the season up against Middlesbrough. And this is my first time editing a video on my channel, like properly cutting out bits and merging them together. So I hope it's all smooth and all that goes well. But their team is no comparison to mine. I left a little bit of this skill game in because I didn't want to cut it out too much. So we start the action off here in the very early stage of the match, and great ball through from Daniel Sturridge through to Kevin Doyle, and check that out for a finish. It was a great goal for Kevin Doyle to score, and Daniel Sturridge was a great ball over the top. That's why we bought him. And so that's 1-0 in the first 10 minutes, and that's a great start for us. But pretty much straight after that, they pretty much went up the other end of the field, played a chip ball over. I didn't know whether to bring Hennessy out or keep him in, but then they crossed it in, and this guy gave a great header, bottom corner. No complaints for that. But they make it 1-1 in the 11th minute, so I don't know what to say, but it was a bit poor, really. Maybe I should have just brought Wayne Hennessy all the way out. So the game's been going for 11 minutes, and it's 1-1, and that was a fair attempt off kickoff. So now we're going to half time, and then Sigurd Garson brings that into the game to make it 2-1 just before half time. And what a great left footed finish that was, top corner. Forgot to hit the replay on there, sorry. So half time it was 2-1, and then pretty much straight away when we come back out, Daniel Sturridge does that. What a goal for his first goal for Wolves, and that was in the 50th minute. So came out all guns blazing in the second half. Got a bit of fortune there, but never mind. You can't complain about the finish. Absolutely brilliant. Just smashes it top corner with his left foot. So now we get a penalty in the, well, pretty much the 60th minute. It was a penalty. Quite clearly brought me down. I pressed the right stick just to flick it past their goalie, and he brought me down, and I keep their sub in just in case anybody wants to see it. But Sigurd Garson is on the penalties, and I make Kevin Doyle a taker now. And unfortunately, bam, straight over. I was really mad. I was angry that I missed it. But not straight away. In the 77th minute, Velotti fights for it, wins the ball, and managed to slot it home. And after that, I decided to make some subs. I got a nice comfortable lead of 4-1, so I'm trying to bring off a few players that are tired, like Velotti, because he's young, he's building up on his stamina. And I'm also going to bring on some other players for people who are tiring, because I don't want to waste their fitness. Fitness could be an issue. Playing a lot of games a season, Championship, there's about 42 games, I think. I believe, anyway. I think there's 24 teams in the Championship, so it makes it 42 because you don't play yourself. So there's my triple substitution. It's 4-1 up in the 80th minute, and then to make it 5-1, Doumbia cuts back in and finishes brilliantly with his left foot. That's why I'm playing him, and thanks for the comment from a friend saying play him. Certainly will now. It's a great finish for a CDM. Cuts inside on his left foot. But have we still got time for one? Yes, we have. A beautiful passing move. Edwards plays it to Doyle. Doyle passes it on to Evans Blake, who's just come on, and finishes it really, really well by the big guy. He's really strong. I really like Ebant Blake, but he hasn't really got a chance for the starting team unless for fitness or injury, because Sigurd Garson and Doyle are both excellent players. Unless Doyle goes, where he might have to play for a bit. But there we go. Kevin Doyle got man of the match with one goal, and he bounced Blake and Sigurd Garson, Velotti, Daniel Sturridge, and I'm forgetting the other one. So there are a couple of the results. Not really much of a shock on the cards, but
Accrington Stanley 0, Oxford United 2,
but
Barnsley
hopefully
3,
we can progress to the
1.
Next round after this.
Blackpool 2,
we'll have to
Watford
see who we draw.
1.
And I see their first game in the Championship is coming up now.
Now
Daniel Sturridge
has
said
that
he had
English
a really
Cup.
Good debut.
Birmingham City
and here comes the
offer
Manchester
from
Cardiff
Doyle.
They
offered
City me like
£5 million,
so I said,
Barnsley entertain Talker United.
Pomelo, so they
perhaps
could have a bit of money.
On the cards as Leicester City host Manchester
but
City.
As you say in a minute, they
Fulham entertain West Bromwich Albion.
For my offer.
Chelsea host
said,
Charlton Athletic. Newcastle United entertain Hull City. Stoke City host Brighton and Hove Albion.
Could you pay five and a half?
Leeds United entertain Queen's Park Rangers.
So you'll see that in the next
Sunderland
episode, hopefully.
Sunderland host Millwall. Meanwhile, Sheffield United entertain Wolverhampton Wanderers.
From them, still not moving on that 5k, 5 million, sorry, but I think they'll move up to the 5k, 500k, sorry, to make it 5.5 million. So, first game now at home against Middlesbrough. Their team, it's not one of the best. They're not really contending for promotion, I do believe.
Sturridge.
To kick us off really early, Daniel Sturridge
plays
a lovely ball.
Takes the shot off. The goal stands.
GF play, something like that.
Well, that was brilliantly put together, that
gets
move.
An outstanding
and
finish
the finish was fantastic.
Certainly was, Martin. Talk about clinical, the way they went from back to front.
Lovely
quite
ball
brilliant.
By Daniel Sturridge. And then even better finish by Milan.
The score is 1-0.
So that makes
Steve
it 1-1.
Run it on two fronts, really.
We do make it 2-0. Kevin Foley, a little bit of skill to cut inside, plays it to Velotti, and Velotti just passes it to Doyle, slots it in the top corner.
Here.
It was a great finish.
It's a goal and it's a superb one.
So
how many players have they got capable of scoring? Too many for the opposition. Martin Murphy, he might have thought that was going to hit the bar, but no, he's just crept under.
If they do say 5.5, we might let him go. We might not see what other strikers we can get for that sort of money. If you do have any ideas, because I haven't played on at the minute, because I've been a bit ill, so I can't really play. So you'll have to leave a comment, saying which one.
Oh,
and then virtually straight off kick-off, Daniel Sturridge brings a knock-on,
and
absolutely smashes
you
it.
You do see this sort of thing more and more often these days. There's so much pace in the game, and also
ticking
the moment. They picked the moment absolutely perfectly this time.
They did, and a great piece.
Good pass.
They pretty much out of the game, so to make it even
Preston
better, Daniel Sturridge makes it
4-0, well,
and
that's widened the gap between these two teams even further.
Into the far corner,
and he's got his second goal of the game,
pace,
and it's very
and
well taken.
Well, a wonderful goal, and when he gets the chance, he makes full use of that opportunity with a wonderful touch.
So now it's
4-0, there's never any doubt.
It's of added time to come.
So half-time now, and Nez is bringing it forward for them.
Can do it again in the second half, we'll have to wait to see, but what a first.
Supplies the finish for them to make it 4-1 at half-time. And then nothing really happened much. I think it was about the 70th minute, so I decided to make some changes just to lighten the game up a bit more. Save energy and all that usual stuff. Bring it on. Pretty much the usual players, just doing a bit of mixing around here, putting them right in the right place. And when I go off on this one, I realise I needed to change one thing, and that was my left mid back into swapping the CDM.
They
so
set it up well for the cross.
A is my left mid, lays off to Edwards, I think it was, who gets
he's doubled his money
lucky.
Here.
It was a great save by the goalie,
manager using all his
sort of kicked it out into the path of Kevin Doyle to make it 5-1. Now, in the 80th minute,
really
Kevin Doyle
plays
a lovely free ball to Edwards. He's
here
just come on as a sub,
he
so he's got the pace, and he just finishes it. No,
this
doesn't sorry. He hits the post.
I'm not quite sure about this injury, but a man who might be able to update us on it down on the touchline, Jeff Shreve.
The thing is down here is he's twisted his knee.
He's got two goals on the bench. So that makes it 6-1 in the 80th minute.
First weekend of the season, a great way
so
to start
hope
it.
This episode,
they've
guys.
Won, and
like
they've really looked
Kevin
the real
Miller,
deal for
the
first 90 minutes. Long way to go,
so
of course.
So hope you enjoyed this episode, guys. Like and subscribe, and there'll be another episode out tomorrow, hopefully. So thanks for watching, and bye.
Well, now let's join...